pretty much all the coolest things we have in the world around us, aircraft, cars, our cell phones, you know, everything that we really get excited about on a daily basis has to do with science and technology.
Science and technology plays a big part with Dallas Area Rapid Transit, and it's only going to play a bigger part in the future. We have this technology behind me now, which is a kiosk that's going to be on each of our 64 platforms. And it's one thing to give the information, but this is interactive. You'll be able to touch the buttons, and it's the way of the future.
We have our commercial aircraft that really work to connect people with their loved ones and allow businesses to operate efficiently on a daily basis. Our defense platforms provide for and protect our warfighters. And then we have satellites, which provide us with things like weather and GPS.
Here at Toyota, we're going through a transformational period. Apart from being the world's leading car manufacturer company, we're moving to be a global mobility company. And for us, mobility means a person being able to move across the country, across the town, or even across the room.
Because of technology and how far we've come over the last few years, DART has been able to make our buses and trains much smarter. They now work with the customer and with the agency, as opposed to just getting you from point A to point B.
Boeing has always made STEM advancement a priority and really invests in kids and the engineers of the future. So when we bring new folks on to our team here at Boeing and anywhere within the STEM industry, we're really looking for an innate curiosity, a hunger to learn, and really a desire to make a difference in the world.
We're looking for students that are interested in tech, that are interested in software development, not just your standard mechanical engineering.
Any kind of interest you might have, there's likely a home for it within some STEM field or some STEM job out in the industry. And so it's a place where really anyone can succeed just with their natural skills and abilities.
So there's always something new. And as the public is demanding those kinds of things, something like public transit, which maybe you don't consider as science and technology, is going to play that much more of an important role.
It's important for children to learn about robotics, coding, all these new emerging technologies so that they're ready to explore and tackle the problems that they're going to be facing in the future.
As an engineer and a mom, I think it's really important that we foster kids and their interest in science and engineering fields. Thankfully, we live in a world that gives tons of opportunities to be able to explore these things.
It's never too early to start kids learning about technology and innovation. And one of the best places to learn about that is at your local public library.
The library is really a great place to jump in and start exploring. You know, it's really a resource that's very accessible for everyone.
They started out by going to school, going to the library, spending their time learning about things, experiencing new technology on their own, then ultimately going off to college and getting better at that.
Boeing is proud to partner with Plano Public Libraries and the City of Plano to promote STEAM within our community.
I love Plano Libraries. Their relationship with STEM is just fantastic.
At Toyota, we are ecstatic to work with the Plano Public Library to help bring out programs that will develop our young children to tackle the problems of the future.
So come to the library and explore.